always failed where others have succeeded.
You said Burt?
Yes, yes. Fortunately, Professor Burroughs took refuge behind a new shipment of inflatable goiters, which cushioned the force of the explosion.
Inflatable goiters?
Yes, it's a Valentine's Day collection.
I detect something in your voice that says I am in disfavor with you.
Most unfortunate, Mr. I'm sorry, I didn't quite get your name. What are you looking at? Oh, sneaking a peek at the upcoming scenes, huh?
Must find that woman.
Kevin, take one. Da-da-da-da.
If someone has been murdered here, please let it be Clouseau, hmm?
Sellers has always been one of my idols.
Is he in the movie?
Yeah, he's in it. Yeah, he plays the role of the Panther.
He plays the role of the Panther?
I guess he immortalized that role. And whoever played Inspector Clouseau was great.
Forever, my little girls, they grow down in the mist. Yes?
The special delivery.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I'm a little sharp.
Forget it.
Most people say the golden age of Hollywood was in the 30s, 40s, or even the 50s. But United Artists and producer-director Blake Edwards turned back the clock to those fabulous days in promoting their newest Peter Sellers comedy, Revenge of the Pink Panther. Some 300 members of the media, celebrities, and guests were flown to Hawaii to attend the World Invitational premiere of this latest Inspector Clouseau comedy classic. The three-day press preview junket included lavish accommodations at the Kuilima Hotel.
Peter, is the toughest part for you of making a film, of selling it after, I mean, not by selling, I mean having to meet with the press and so forth?
Is that... What do you mean, like we're doing now?
Yeah.
Well, I think it would be tougher, you know, if we had to travel around to do it. I think it's much better doing the old-style Hollywood junket like this, where you get to meet everybody the one time, even if it is a bit exhausting. Than sort of, say, traveling around publicizing the movie. I wouldn't do that anyway. I don't believe in that. I believe that dear Gary Cooper, God rest his soul, used to say, and that was, if the movie is any good, that it, you know, it will talk for itself. It will do its own word of mouth, you know. Ideally, I never go to a screening. I always, as you remember probably from La Costa, I stayed out and had friends go in and say, tell me how it was going, you know.
Did you go to the theater? Outside the theater?
Yeah, I wasn't in at La Costa. I didn't go into the theater.
How about here?
Oh, I went into the theater here because I hadn't seen the film, you see, and I wanted very much to see how it had turned out.
Everybody was in hysterics laughing.
4 armed robberies in 3 weeks. 2 of the victims were assaulted and grappled with the robber. Both the victims felt the robber was much too strong to be a woman. 3 years ago, we sent to prison a man named Claude Russo. Russo committed robberies disguised as a woman.
Well, sir, I must be off to apprehend this mad Vienna now.
remember, It just could be Russo.
Yes, it just could be Russo, yes.
Yes, I just said that.
Yes, I know that, yes, sir. Well, sir, until we meet again and the case is solved.
According to the coroner's report, Chief Inspector Clouseau was probably dead before his car hit the telephone pole and burst into flames.
Peek-a-boo.
Spark that began this flip-flop.
That's always hard to answer. I really don't know how to answer those things. We just started talking about it. I had an idea some time ago when I was thinking of Strikes Again and Return Up and things like that.
As in every stone of this size, there is a flaw.
A flaw?
The slightest flaw. If you look deep into the stone, you will perceive the tiniest discoloration. It resembles an animal.
An animal?
Little panther.
Yes, a pink panther.
But he was sort of a social outcast in the jungle because he was a different color, and that he was terribly erudite and never said anything. Therefore, he was very expressive because he had to use hands or paws in his case, and very suspect by the other animals because of his intelligence and because he was different.
My kink, he knows it, Hank. Had a roast for that glorious colored creature, what might you say about him?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. He never called me to thank me for writing the theme.
Okay, we're going to hold a roast for the Pink Panther. If you had to help roast the Pink Panther, what would you say about it?
If I had to help roast the Pink Panther?
You know, all of the roasts where you stand up and say, usually cutting things.
I would say, I'm a vegetarian.
Well, that's good. He'd like that.
I'm not
going to
touch you, Pink Panther.
That'd be
I'm not going to touch you one little hair on your beautiful little body.
What about this old Pink Panther? He's sitting back of you. And
I don't know. I've never really thought about him very much, except that he's all given us work.
It's been suggested that we have a roast for the Pink Panther, grand fellow that he is. What might Peter Sellers say about his old friend, the Pink Panther? You've been with him a long time.
I would say that he's getting pinker every day.
human form, Inspector Clouseau?
Not really. I don't think so. I think that they are probably... they are diametrically opposed. Clouseau is timeless because he represents something in all of us that doesn't change, essentially. Speech... words may change... certain customs may change, but the essential man doesn't change. Clouseau doesn't. The fallible, bumbling screw-up, if you will. He's essential in all of us, and he provides us with the ability to laugh at ourselves.
I hate you. Every little bit of you. Now get out! You want me to leave?
Madame, it is my business to look at trouble. No trouble back there.
Now I know why this place looks so familiar.
Why?
Chief Inspector Dreyfus lives here. I think he has received the faint. Wake up, Chief Inspector! Wake up! Chief Inspector! Hello? Are you in there, Chief Inspector? Hello? There's no reply. It's no use. I think we will have to go to Hong Kong without him.
Uh-huh. Caught you peeking at those clips again, didn't I?
Nobility about Clouseau, because he tries. Against all odds, he tries.
I don't think I can do this.
Of course you can. Of course you can. Just think yellow and follow me.
But these are not normal times, Cato. Someone has just tried to kill me.
That's normal.
Ah.
Of course, he's pompous, and he's arrogant, he's accident-prone. All of the qualities that we can attribute to any one of us at almost any given time. I think that's one of the things that makes him attractive.
There is something that I am very interested to know. This room looks very... What happened? What?
Clouseau is no ordinary man.
A smart operator can clear himself a couple of hundred grand, and that ain't exactly chicken feed.
No. No. In 10 years on Devil's Island, ain't exactly the chicken's feed either, my greedy little yellow pimp.
Ow! Never before has his mind been more brilliant.
But that's a priceless Steinway.
Not anymore.
He allows it to take form by supposedly practicing self-defense. He makes it a game. It's his way of blowing off steam, so to speak. And again, he reflects all of us. His sneaky way of attacking Cato is the way that an awful lot of us sneakily, one way or another, attack others. It allows us again to be able to laugh at the very things that we harbor in our own black souls. We make fun of it.
I will do as soon as I get home, provided that idiot Cato does not attack me first.
Why don't you just tell him not to?
Believe me. It's not that easy. I have given him instructions to attack me wherever and whenever possible.
and it has now become a matter of pride with him to try to outsmart me. I guarantee that at this very minute his fiendish little yellow brain is plotting some new ambush.
Inspector Clouseau's residence. One moment, please. Commissioner Dreyfus.
The phone is ringing.
Relax, I'll get it.
There's nothing new in comedy, nor is there really anything new in drama. It's all been done before us, and we either consciously or subconsciously collect from our masters. I think that you could point to just about any of the great comedians and say, is there something similar to that moment and something that Chaplin may have done or Keaton or any one of those?
Well, do you want to take six? Pick up.
Just give me 2 hours.
They each had their own individual character. That's what begins to differentiate between the comedians. Not so much what they do, but who they are doing it.
I don't think you understand, monsieur. I am Inspector Clouseau of the...
Hello, boys! Oh, am I glad to see you?
And we are certainly glad to see you.
Hey. Wait a moment. You know me, I'm Chief Inspector Clouseau of the Sûreté.
And I am Officer Bardot.
Bardot?
But you can call me Brigitte.
Brigitte! Listen, Brigitte! You're making an understandable mistake. Don't let my legs fool you. I'm really a man. Listen.
I am none other than Chief Inspector Jacques Clouseau.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
I am.
You're not.
I am.
You're not. You are not.
No.
No, you're not. Yes, you are. Oh, my God.
Yes, I admit it's not a very good photograph.
We found that we could play around with words then. We started on this thing with the French language, which we didn't use at all in the first Pink Panther.
Oui, monsieur.
Do you have a rhin?
A rhin?
What?
You said, do I have a rhin?
I know perfectly well what I said. I said, do you have a rhin? And if it has a bath, it might go easier for you.
What do you mean, do I have a room?
That is what I've been saying, you fool.
You didn't even arrest the old beggar.
There was some question as to whether the beggar or his minky was breaking the law.
Minky?
What?
You said minky.
That is correct, yes. Chimpanzee minky. So I left them both off with a warning.
The beggar was the lookout man for the gang.
That is impossible.
Why?
He was blind. How can a blind man be a lookout?
I was hit on the head.
Yes.
You have received a bimp upon the head.
Bimp?
What?
You said bimp.
Yes, I know that. It is a large bimp. You could receive the concussion from such a bimp.
We tend to live in our fantasies too much, and when reality comes up to smack us in the face, why, we have to be pretty resilient. It's that way when you're writing comedy.
I have. Well...
Are you all right, former Chief Inspector?
Yes! Yes, I'm perfectly... All right. See?
You imagine something and you try very hard based on past experience, what you know, what you've seen.
to design it so that it is real.
The bomb? It was meant for you.
What do you mean it was meant for me, Commissioner?
Doorman, two customers on the Cossack, and now six more innocent people.
They were all murderers except Maurice, who was a blackmailer, Commissioner.
Compared with you, they were all saints.
Commissioner, please, what are you doing?
I hate you, Clouseau.
Commissioner, please.
I hate you.
Commissioner, what are you doing to me? Let go of me. Commissioner, let go of my leg. You're hercules.
His kind will not pass this way again, and our loss is surely heaven's gain.
It's a nerve-wracking business, I can tell you.
I haven't closed my eyes in 3 days. I've only eaten a chicken leg and some clear broth since Wednesday. I'm cracking up. I'm coming apart at the seams. Look at my eye. I used to have a perfectly good eye. My two eyes, I mean. No, doctor, there is no hope. There is no hope unless I can get rid of Clouseau.
It's a birthday gift from my wife.
Now, what seems to have stopped? Probably due to the explosion. You need a new flint.
Don't just stand there, idiot. Call a doctor. And then help me find my doze.
I wish you were dead. Well, of course, you are entitled to your opinion.
How can an idiot be a policeman? Answer me that!
It's very simple. All he has to do is enlist.
Cut it!
It's an absurd point of view about life and about situations. It allows one to play God or dad or something Oedipal like that, and I guess that's a requirement of mine. I enjoy the fairy tale aspect of it. I guess that's the child in me, or the child in most filmmakers.
Briefly, 5, take 2.
Action. That's it. You can do it, Inspector.
Chief Inspector.
You can walk, Chief Inspector. You can walk.
Yes. You're a genius, Burt. I can walk. Oh, thank heavens. The little guy.
Right, here we go. Now, stay quiet.
Go, I'm going to say. And go, you move on, go. He pushes on, go.
All right, take light. Roll low.
Do you want to take one,
Inspector? B. Everybody going?
Everybody's going.
1, 2, 3, go! Hold it! Right.
Things are very fishy in Denmark.
Switzerland?
Yes, there too.
Guten Tag.
Good day.
My name is John Cassavetes. I'm interested in motor noise.
What happened in the car, Stone?
Well, it was a Mercedes. We had to take off the side of a wharf
onto three Chinese junks, about a 50-foot leap.
Now, how much planning goes into an operation like that?
Well, there's quite a bit goes on because you've got to size up how far the car's going to go. So obviously you take the car onto a deserted road or an airport strip or somewhere and put a ramp up and leap it. And then you weight the back of the car so it won't tip down too much. And you take the speed and things like that. And you just go on from there.
And what sort of precautions did you take in case the car landed in the water?
Well, the three guys that were doing it, we had a main driver and two passengers. We had an air bottle in a boot with three tubes leading out, mouthpieces attached to them, of course, and we had divers standing by, and we had equipment in the car so they could break out if anything did happen, if the car turned upside down and went in the water or nosedived into the water, and that's a precaution we took on that one.
But in any stunt like that, you're never 100% sure.
No, not 100%. You never can be.
For me, it's the ultimate form of expression. It encompasses all of the senses, really. Sight, sound, maybe even eventually touch and smell. Who knows where it's going to go. But I think it's essentially that. It's a means of expression for me that transcends writing or painting, any of those one-dimensional things.
Oh.
Parallel bars. Reminds me of my younger days at the police academy. I used to be quite an athlete, you know. My speciality, the bars. They used to call me...
Take four.
Ah, 16 chests on the dead man's rum. Yeah, 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 and a bottle of chest. Drink till the devil won't stand from the van. Oi, oi, oi. Keep your... Burden, all fluid, not a burden. Keep your eyes and ears peeled. Keep in constant contact. I am extremely grateful for this excellent piece of information. Barship blues!
Rather like Laurel and Hardy that way. His sense of humor is very much like mine.
That dope.
Because I'm taller than you are, you fool.
Oh, yeah.
Make a cradle. But get rid of that.
The same sort of things as I do, funny. Little dogs and cats and birds, all kinds of things like that, funny. Situations, he spots them very quickly. And we both see the funny, and he's also a great giggler.
Is your dear goodbye?
No.
Nice, dear. I thought you said your dog did not bite.
That is not my dog.
In a comedy, what you do generally better be funny. I mean, by that, you can't afford too many bad jokes in a film. Just a few bad ones will permeate the whole film.
and it's gone. Whereas a drama can go up and down. It could have a bad performance here and a great performance over there. And there's enough redeeming features in it to save the end result. In a comedy, if it's not funny, it's not good. And it's just that simple.
Follow that car!
Mutual admiration doesn't only go to Clouseau, but goes to each other, so which is a big help in creating Clouseau.
It takes off a few loops, Joe. You know, we see, he's carrying the thing closely. Throws it, it's got to pull him in. And once you've made your choice, go pretty quickly there. Take one loop off, that's right.
Peter Sellers and Blake Edwards are constantly polishing the image of Inspector Clouseau. They ply each other with fresh ideas, interpreting, rehearsing, and shooting visual comedy on locations all over Europe. Edwards envisions comical pictures and puts those ideas to paper. Sellers sees in the written word the outrageous moves that millions have come to know and expect from the great fumbler.
Do you know the way to
it's defense? Like a musician's ear when he knows that somebody is playing a piece of music the slightest bit incorrectly.
141, take 8. Actor!
Eventually, when you do it enough times wrong, hopefully you find the answer and you find the right way to do it.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Do you know the way to the Palace Hotel?
Yes.
Take 2.
Right. Special delivery at Ben. Where were you expecting what?
Thank you.
talked over the years about doing another one. But it really was the kind of talk that Peter and I indulge in. A kind of stimulating type of fun that is indigenous to Inspector Clouseau and the Panther. But I don't think there was ever any really serious intention to do another one. And suddenly I was faced with the possibility of doing it. I talked to Sellers. And we finally said, as is our way quite often, oh, what the hell, let's do it.
To the Gannett transaction. Shall I talk to Duvier? We're on our way. Don't forget the money.
What? Don't! Back! Choking! You want me to hit you on the back?
Savoir de fond ton miséricordiam, fonction sur non réservicem, qui toi votis tu es volontate, ut secuti un fiat fiuti filum tomis, itas le corispe Christum Domium nostrum. Amen. Requiem eternam donai Domine, et plus.
Fortunately, I was saved by the darkness.
So what we need is more light.
I believe while you were in Hong Kong, you had a slight embarrassment with an ice cream cart.
Slightly embarrassing, yes. I was supposed to come running out of the hotel, looking for a means of transport. The only available means of transport was an ice cream scooter. And we had local police looking after us. And I came running out of the hotel, jumped on the scooter, drove off with it, in, I thought, a very creative manner, which meant driving it rather erratically. Next thing I knew, I heard people shouting behind me, saying, stop, where are you going? Why? And it turned out that the police thought that I had come running out of the hotel and stolen the film company's scooter. So they arrested me. Having arrested me, they asked me for my license. I didn't have it on me. It was up in the hotel room. So we had to leave somebody as a hostage while I went and got my license and brought it back and cleared it up that way.
What is this fearsome fighting method that you do?
The method is Kempo, is what it's called. And it's a more innovative method that's over and above Kung Fu, if you know what that is.
Gentlemen, fulfill your contract. Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Peter Sellers, where we are celebrating the world premiere of The Revenge of the Pink Panther. And I think that's Peter Sellers over there. I know this is Lynn Frederick, I'm sure. What are you doing with that microphone?
And then it's a new nasal microphone.
You dropped your nasal microphone.
Yes, I did. Yes, it's got the nostril impedance.
Is that so? Yes.
It's two nostril ohms to the wire, and it was perfected by Dr. Goebbels for the German Ministry of Propaganda. I'm a keen follower of these things, you know.
You knew. Lynn, do you laugh at everything he does?
Most things.
Does he keep you laughing all the time?
No, not all the time. No, no.
This is Shirley Eder, regretfully taking leave of Mr. and saying. Mrs. Peter Panther. Peter Sellers.
Let's do one more definitive close-up. It was just that kind of thing. It's fun. It's the most fun we've ever had making film.
We have the best script, I think, going in. We've got a great set of actors, and what we've shot so far looks like the funniest of all we've done.
Déjà vu.
I have it all the time.
Oh, déjà vu. Thank you. Oh, you're welcome. You okay?
Yes. That feels good.
Well, you know, it's not going to do you much good if you don't take your pants off.
What?
You gotta take your pants off. Look at me. Look at me. Look at my foot. I'm shaking like a leaf.
Yes.
I can't stop shaking. I don't know. Oh, I know what it is. You know what it is?
What?
I'm just not used to being killed. I mean, that's my first time, you know?
I know. But listen, when you have been killed as many times as I have, you'll get used to it, believe me.
I've never had so much fun in my life.
If you're talking about this Duvier, but Philippe, who is Philippe?
Philippe Duvier.
His son?
Whose son?
Duvier.
He has no son.
His brother, then?
His brother's name is Fred.
Then it has to be his father.
His father's dead.
Ah, now we're getting somewhere. Then who killed him?
No, and he died of natural causes.
Then who is this Philippe?
If we come up with it this time, and I think we will, because this, as far as I can see, as far as you can ever tell, is the best one we've ever made.
Allow me to let you in the car. Please.
Beautiful.
It's rather neat, isn't it? I call it the Silver Hornet. Yes, service. It's a little overdue for service, unfortunately. Perhaps it's better to leave that there.
Well, it's a beautiful night. Why don't we walk?
What an excellent idea. I'm sorry about that.
Beautiful.
My goodness, you look ravishing tonight.
Oh, yes, I know that.
You know that?
Oh, yes, I know that.
Yes, I knew that.
Stop playing the music, I say to you.